drop. Not for real, y'all. It's your girl, Sweet Pea, back with another entertaining video. So, I bought this wig right there that you see from AprilLaceWigs.com. I've never worn any of their products before, so I'm curious to see how it stands up to the competition. You know, I'm going to let y'all know. It is a 16-inch, 13x4 lace front wig. Lace in the front, tracks in the back, you know. And I did play around with it. I plucked the edges. I added some color to it because when I first bought it, it was black. And I used sunrise orange. And I used raspberry prism. And I had like a tablespoon left of red. So it was no point in it just sitting there, the whole bottle with just a little bit of stuff. But what? Stop rushing me. I can't stand when people rush me. Here I come, y'all. But anyway, I just poured the rest of the red in there. And this is what I came up with. But without further ado, like, subscribe, hit that notification button. Comment, leave a comment. What y'all want to see next? What's up? Oh yeah, you guys, this wig is so beautiful. It's soft, it's super wavy. It's your standard lace 13x4 lace in the front with the tracks in the back. Came with all your standard combs, one in the middle, one on each side, and one in the back. But y'all know my head is a peanut head, so I'm actually going to have to size this wig to fit. So let's get into it. Y'all know the deal. I just did the regular ball cap method, the OG one, where you don't have to put it over your ears. And I'm just cutting the lace off. I'm going to clean it up a little bit. Y'all know what to do. So just watch me work. I ain't going to be talking through the whole thing. Just watch me work. Look, it's just so much easier when you cut this lace in three, just section it up. I know I'm not the only one this happened to. Sometimes you guys just have to bring that lace back, that cap back a little bit and trim some off. Because if you don't, it's going to be showing. You just got to do what you got to do to get it right. You guys, I always start at the bottom. At least I try to start at the bottom because, you know, the bottom takes so long to dry. You be done started at the top. And when you got down to the bottom, the top be dry because it's always so thin. So I just start at the bottom now. That way it comes on evenly. It's always super thick and nice. Give it a try. Let me know how you like it. I'm gonna put some extra air on it, let it get tacky real quick for y'all. Now I'm just lining it up with my hairline so I can see where it's gonna be. Taking my rat tooth comb and combing out them hair so it won't be all stuck. Y'all know how it be sometimes. It really like takes me forever and a day to like do the baby hairs. I am not good at doing baby hair. I need like so much practice. I'm like so old school when you just brush all that shit down and just do one long stripe. So yeah, I wasn't gonna flat iron it or curl it or anything like that today. I was just doing a simple style, just the installation with a little bit of baby hairs, straightened out the edges a little bit so the edges can look like it's melting into that scalp. And I'ma just wet it a little bit and go. I really like the dry look. Normally I would like to just take a little bit of oil sheen and spray it in the palm of my hand. And just like kind of graze the hair just a little bit so it can have that angel soft look. That's the look that I really like, but it didn't seem right without me spraying nothing on it. But yeah, just something simple, something to go to the grocery store, go to the mailbox, just something simple. Blending in any imperfections with my pressed powder. And as always, I appreciate you guys so much. Here's the finished look. I really appreciate you guys for watching. Please continue to support your girl. I need all the support I could get. Like, subscribe, comment, say hi. What y'all want to see next?